Welcome to Chemistry with Caroline. In this video, we're going to take a look at nucleophiles and electrophiles. So we'll start with the nucleophile. Nucleophile literally means something that likes the nucleus. So if we think about the nucleus, it's got the protons and the neutrons in there. Protons are positively charged. So a nucleophile is something that it likes or is attracted to a positive charge. So if we think about chemistry, opposites attract in chemistry. So generally speaking, a nucleophile is either going to be negatively charged or have a partial negative charge associated with it. And then it would be attracted to another molecule that has a positive or a partial positive charge. So a couple of examples might be a sulfide type ion, where you have a sulfur with a full negative charge on it. Or you could have a water molecule, would be an example of a molecule that has polarized bonds. So if we think about the dipole moments associated with this oxygen, there's a partial negative charge on the oxygen and partial positive charges on the hydrogens. So the oxygen would be a nucleophilic atom. Electrophiles, on the other hand, like electrons. Electrons are negatively charged, and in chemistry, since opposites attract, electrophiles are going to either have a positive or a partial positive charge. So some examples of electrophilic atoms would be the carbonyl carbon. So again, if we think about dipole moments, there's a dipole moment going towards the oxygen. So the oxygen is partial negative, the carbon is partial positive. So this carbon would be an electrophilic carbon, and a nucleophile would be attracted to it. Another example would be a carbocation. This has a full positive charge on it. Those are common intermediates in organic reactions. And it's a really good electrophile because it has a full positive charge. It's deficient a full octet, and so it's going to be very reactive and very susceptible to nucleophilic attack. So now let's look at a chemical reaction where a nucleophile and an electrophile come together. So here I have my nucleophile on the left. Remember, the nucleophile has an affinity for positive charge, so it's going to be negative or partially negatively charged. And then my electrophile is going to have a partial positive or a positive charge. It has an affinity for electrons. So these two can come together. The nucleophile is going to donate the electrons, and the electrophile is going to accept those electrons. And that will form this new molecule here. So this has been an introduction to nucleophiles and electrophiles. If you found this video helpful, please like, subscribe, and share with your friends.